Kiwi's World. If you are new to my channel, please comment, like, and subscribe. And today I wanted to talk about therapy and Christianity. There are a lot of Christians out there that don't know whether they should take that step of therapy or not, or they're, you know, they're battling with it. So I just want to give you guys some quick advice on that. So for me, I'm starting therapy tomorrow, which is like mind-blowing to me, because let me just take it back. Like, so at the beginning of this quarantine, I prayed that I would get closer to God. Like, I really want to be closer to God. Like, that's one of the biggest things that I wanted to do aside from open up my business. So when I prayed that, I didn't know what it would come with. So God immediately started talking to me more, like just allowing me to completely feel his presence. It's amazing. Like, because, you know, being in like my apartment by myself, you know, it's very quiet. So the fact that like God is just like letting me know, he's reassuring me constantly that he's here with me and I'm not going through this by myself, it was really like, it really like touched my heart. Basically, I've been through a lot of trauma from my childhood up into the age of, I would say, like 21 or 22. And it was something that I never dealt with. So pretty much like, because I didn't deal with that trauma, now it's resurfacing. And it affects my emotions. It affects the way that I treat people, which I don't like, because I don't want people to think that I'm this mean person. It affects my friendships. It's affected relationships. It's affected a lot of things. So recently I was just talking to my boyfriend, which is like, that's God sent, because like, but yeah, that's another story. But basically I was talking to him and he just like told me straight up, like, I love that he's so honest with me. He told me straight up, he's like, you know, like, maybe you should look into going to therapy, because there's a lot of things I see about you changing. And he didn't like it. Like, I was just in awe that he was so honest with me. I wasn't even mad, because I want to be the best version of myself when I'm with him. So I don't want to give him anything less than that. Like, nobody deserves mediocre love. Pretty much how I went about finding a therapist. I already know my insurance is like trash. I know health insurance is trash. So basically there's this thing called the EAP, and you get it through your job, which they offer you counseling services. I don't know if your job has it, but my job does. Some jobs have it, some jobs don't. And pretty much it's counseling for anything, post-traumatic stress disorder, depression, anxiety, anything that you need. So they cover three of the counseling services, and then I handle it after that. And basically when I called them, they were like, yeah, I'm gonna give you, they gave me pretty much a top five of therapists that were in my area. And from that list, I went through and I researched and I spoke to these therapists and I was like, okay, this is the therapist that I want. So I went through, I picked the therapist, we spoke over the phone, we did a short consultation, and like, she's really, really like, she helped me with the cost. Like, it's not expensive as you guys think it is. I know that's one reason why people don't go into therapy, because they think it's like, oh, it's so expensive. Or if you think like, oh, I'm not crazy, it's not about you being crazy. It's all about you healing. Because sometimes there's a lot of trauma that we go through when we're younger that we don't heal from in our adult life. And when it resurfaces, it can be in the most, I don't even know how to describe it. It can be in the most terrible way. And you don't want that. You don't want that to ruin friendships or relationships and stuff like that. I don't believe that God is against therapy. I believe that God would push us towards therapy because he knows that's where we're gonna find the healing. That's where we're gonna be set free from a lot of things. And I don't think that is something that Christians should frown upon. Granted, God is our savior. I agree 100% with that. God will save you. God will heal you. But when you know that you need somebody else to help you through this, it's okay. It's okay to look for help. This is why God has placed therapists and doctors in the world. It's okay to ask for help. It's okay, because sometimes I feel like in a Christian community, it can be so overwhelming when people constantly tell you, hey, pray about it, you're gonna be okay, pray about it. Granted, prayer changes things. I'm not taking away from anything that prayer does, but I know for sure that God didn't just put people on this earth to just be like, okay, there's a therapist there, you know, like that's it. Like, no, use the people that you have access to. Like, learn from these people, like engage in talks with these people, like be set free ultimately. And yeah, there's a lot of online therapy that you can search out as well, but you know, I'm not too good with the online therapy. I wanted somebody that was close to me, number one. So her office is like, it's very close to me. It's like 15 minutes away from me. So when Corona and everything is more settled down, I'll probably be having more office visits with her. But I wanted somebody that was like in my state. Like I wanted somebody that was in Miami. I wanted somebody that had a lot of experience. I just wanted somebody that was like me. And she had to be a Black woman. I'm sorry, that's just my preference. Like, but you know, everybody's different. If you prefer a male therapist versus a female, you can do that as well, you know. But just make sure you're doing it for the right reasons. Make sure your heart is in the right place. And just find that ultimate and true healing. Like, God has been so good to me this quarantine, and I'm so glad that he spoke to me, because now I'm just thinking back to, okay, God, wow, just wow. Like, if quarantine didn't happen, then I wouldn't have this opportunity to completely heal from these traumas. So thank you. Like, even though everything is shut down, even though it's like, it seems like the world is so crazy, like, God is still working. He's still working for the greater good of us. Like, he's still there with us. He's still, like, you know, like, pushing past mountains with us. He's still climbing over those mountains. You know, he's moving things out of the way. He's allowing us to access, like, the best versions of ourselves. And, like, I'm not even mad. I'm in awe of the way that he's working in my life. I know that therapy is going to change me. It's going to make me way more open than I am right now. And, yeah, I just want to ultimately heal from a lot of that past trauma. Like, trauma, I feel like as Black women especially, like, we're taught to just be strong. That's what we are. Like, we are taught to just be strong. Oh, you can't cry. Like, you know, like, I've even seen that in the Black community with men. Like, oh, men can't cry, or it makes them less of a man and stuff like that. And for me, that's very traumatic, because, like, I'm a very sensitive person. So in order for me to, like, hold in my feelings, that's like, you know, I'm losing a piece of myself, because I'm not ultimately releasing how I feel. And that's a dangerous game that you don't want to play. So if you were seeking therapy, just do it. Like, find yourself. You're going to find, and it's so much easier. I guarantee you, it's so much easier to talk to a stranger about your problems than to talk to your friend or someone that you know. It's great to seek counsel for your friends. It's great. But therapy is getting that professional help that you need, you know? Like, doctors see things from a different perspective. Like, I know she's going to be picking my mind tomorrow, you know, like, trying to see where my headspace is, giving me, you know, like, challenging things that, like, that will help me overcome my trauma. Like, I know she's going to be great. And it's just like, you want that for yourself. Friends are great to talk to, but they're not therapists. Like, you know, therapists understand why we do what we do, why we feel what we feel, you know? So, yeah. That was just a mouthful I said, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And yeah, just pray for the best, and you're gonna be okay. So thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and bye. I'll see you next time.